you. Thank you very much. Thank you. I knew George Stevens as a man of integrity. I saw that integrity reflected in his films. I worked with George for a few days on The Greatest Story Ever Told, where I saw his strength and artistry and had the pleasure of his company. That was a long way from his Laurel and Hardy days, but the humor was still there. Even though the production had been snowed out in Monument Valley, and he was 2 months behind schedule. George's integrity was reflected in many ways. It is well known that he took the lead in the struggle at the Directors Guild during the McCarthy era, when there was a plot to oust Joseph Mankiewicz as president of the Guild. Those were frightening times, and George stepped forward to stand up for his friend and mine, and for the integrity of the Guild. When NBC wanted to cut A Place in the Sun for television in 1963, George took both NBC and Paramount to court to defend the integrity of his film, and in a large sense, the rights of all filmmakers. As he put it, the audience should be respected by being presented a film as they remember it, and for those who have not seen it, as it was intended to be seen. Anything less is a degradation of the film and its audience, unquote. Earlier in 1942, when he was finishing The More the Merrier and had become one of the most successful directors in Hollywood, he made the choice to go to war, put in for a commission, and got it. He was 38 years old, well beyond the draft. As George put it, quote, "The war was on in North Africa, and it's hard to get a 50-yard line seat like that." In 1944, General Eisenhower put Lieutenant Colonel Stevens in charge of combat photography for D-Day and the war in Europe. Quote, "The Stevens Irregulars," unquote, as they were known, recorded the war on 35mm black and white film for the newsreels at home and for history. George took along his own 16mm camera, and he and his men in his Jeep shot their own unique diary of the war in color. George's son used that color film in George Stevens, A Filmmaker's Journey. It is George Stevens' view of a great moment in history. It, too, reflects the integrity I admire.